Hello and welcome to this episode of Makerbox Models. In this episode I'm gonna have a look, or try to have a look, at Gizmodorks POM material called POM Acetal Black. I'm not sure how to say it, but let's have a look at the intro and I'll show you more. So here on the label, you can see how it's spelled out, POM Acetal. I'm not sure how to say this word, but here they say hot end temperature should be 250 to 230, bed temperature should be 130 degrees, and I was not able to reach that temperature on my printer. Speed 30 millimeters per second, and here they say polyoxymethylene POM. Filament is also known as acetal, I can't say that word, polyacetal or derlin, extremely strong, durable engineering polymer, heated enclosure and fume management advised. That's no joke. I gave up on this filament because of the fumes of it. It was overtaking my apartment. Here you can see my results. I was unable to go anywhere from the first layer. I was trying to print on various materials and found out that I could print out on paper by basically gluing paper on the PI sheet and then printing on paper, but even then the layer adhesion on the paper was an issue because it started to warp just as I was printing a little bit, maybe two layers, it just ripped up the printer. You can see here it's just a whole mess. And it's I was trying to print with a wide brim, and finally just gave up because the fumes from this material was overtaking everything. I was having my door opened on my balcony door and trying to get a stable temperature in the enclosure, but reaching bed temperature of 130 is something I can't do on my printer. I don't think a normal household printer is able to make anything out of this filament. I have the rest of it here, and I don't think I will be able to make anything out of it. This material is too much of an engineering material for me, in my household at least. If you have an environment where you can try it out a little bit, maybe it's a good idea to use this material. But because of the fumes, I don't think it's a good idea for a household 3D printer to tackle. But your mileage may vary on what you have. Maybe you need a specially enclosed heated chamber to be able to use this material. I don't know. I try to look up videos on people having success with this material. But this is one of the things that I love about the Makerbox. You get some materials that you have absolutely no way of printing on your printer. And of course, people may have various printers and environments, and some may be able to print with this material. But normal users, I don't think they will be successful. But if you are able to use this material in your environment, please let me know in the comments what environment you have to make any use of this filament. But this will be it for this video. I thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next one.